Okay. Got something pretty special in here. And I've only found one of these like one other time when I was younger. And it was last night. It was right before dark, and I was just messing around. I'm surprised I found this thing. And I saw a little tail poking out, and I thought it was probably a ground skink. And so I grabbed it anyway. And once I did, it held onto the dirt, and I knew, I was like, there's no way it was a skink, because it held on. And I kept pulling on it, it would not come out. And finally, when I got it out, he is a really neat little snake. And you can probably tell what it is from what I've got him in. I took a bunch of pot and soil and put in here, and of course he disappeared. And this snake has the same characteristics as the worm. And it actually looks a lot like a worm. So let me try to see if I can find him. He's really fast. There he is. And this is the eastern worm snake. Really small little snake. They're real secretive. You'll usually find them under like decaying logs. They feed on termites, worms. He's got a really small little head. And you can barely see his eyeballs, but they're there. And he resembles a worm. Like, from a distance, you would never know that this was a snake. But now, if you look at his belly, it's almost transparent. You can actually see some of his organs down in there. And if you look really closely. And also, one neat feature about the snake is right here. He's got a really pointy tail, and he'll dig into you with it. But it doesn't really hurt, but I'm guessing that's some kind of defense mechanism to try to get predators away, or he might use it to dig in the dirt, I don't know. But it's a really interesting little snake, and we didn't really have any small, you know, like smaller species of snakes, you know. We have the ribbon snake, but they're not that small. But this little thing, he's really small, and I thought this was a really cool one to find. I thought the first one I saw would either be a crown snake or maybe a brown snake or a ringneck, but yeah, this was something else. And I found him under a cooler right over there, and he was halfway in the leaves, and I grabbed him just in time, because most of the time, once you lift something up, you barely see them and they're gone. And just, yeah, this little guy, I got him just in time, and he's very interesting looking. It's a cool little thing. He's got a very small little head. You can see he's pretty squirmy, just like a worm. Can you see him good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and here's the length of him. Not real big, and they do get a little bigger than this, but I mean not a whole lot bigger. So yeah, this is, thought he was really neat. I like his belly too. That's one of his most important features. And this is the eastern one. Their bellies are a little more pinkish than the western. So, but yeah. Can you see his little eyeballs? Okay, he's trying to calm. He's coming down. Ferocious. He's a killer. This is a man-eater. You gotta be real careful. Yeah, squirmy. He just wants to get away so bad. And even as I'm holding him, he's just trying to dig, just like he would in the dirt. He's trying to dig down, see how he does that with his head? He's trying to dig down to my skin. So, but yeah, he's cool. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna take him and show you where I found him. And he's going to be released there, get some good photos before we release him, and he's going to take off back down into the dirt. So thanks for watching. Alright guys, I thought maybe real quick I'm going to show you, demonstrate how fast he can go into the soil. And check this out, a lot faster than a worm, that's for sure. Watch this. Disappears. Time for him to go back where we found him, and hopefully we'll find more in the future. Here he goes. You see?